Hi guys, so welcome to this video. In this video we are going to create an impeller using Creo Parametric. So if you are new to our channel, so please subscribe for the new content. So let's get into the video. So now let's create our part. Let's click in new, then enter the part name as impeller, then unclick the default template, click OK and select MMNS part solid. So switch on this all. So now we need to use the revolve option. For that I am selecting the front plane and go for the revolve. Let's go for the sketch view. So now I'm going to draw a line here like this without any dimensions. So now let's go for the dimensions. This line value is 0.13 and this length must be 3 and this height is 1.50 and this length is 0.5. So our sketch may look too small. So because of this MMNS part solid, we are using every unit as mm. So then draw an arc from this plane to this point. So you can draw arc which is depend upon you. I want this size, so my arc radius is 0.5, so 2.50. So then I am going to draw a central plane which is must for the revolve option and I am going to click OK. So now our part is completed. I am going to click OK. So now we need to search, okay, this is the right plane here. So I am going to create a plane for the right plane towards the right direction and enter a value of 1.50 as it is there. No need to enter it, 1.50. Then clicking on OK. Then I am going to create another plane to this right plane up to this surface. Select this surface and select this plane. So it is parallel to the selected plane. So I am going to click OK. So then let's go for the diagram. So at first select this right plane and go for the sketch and sketch view. At first we need to create a reference line for the top reference and the bottom reference. Close it. So now let's draw an arc from this point to this point to a radius of 1 and I am going to click this as OK. So now select the second plane that we created and go for the sketch and sketch view. So create the reference as same that we created for the last. Unclick the reference that we created, an arc. So now select an arc. Okay. From this plane to this reference. And I need this value to be 0.53. And this arc radius is 0.7. So our second sketch is completed. So I'm going to give OK for this and let's go for the third plane and go for the sketch view. Now we need to create another reference here, here and here and the reference for the newly created arc. So now I'm going to create a spline to this arc reference. Draw without any dimensions, then we can enter lately. So after you getting this, click on escape button. You can adjust it by select option and you can drag it like this. So I think it's okay for me. And the top dimension is of value 0.25 and the bottom is a value of 0.1. yeah, it's right for me. So I'm going to reduce this value as 0.2. So now it look okay. Or you can reduce it by 1.5. Okay, sorry, 0.15. So then we are going to draw a line from this point towards downwards, and I'm going to enter the dimension as 0.05. Then I'm going to click this OK. So we created a three lines here, here and here. So I'm going to create a boundary blend here. Select this line, control this line and this line. So part is completed. So I'm going to give OK here. So then we are going to pattern this. So at first, for our confusions, I'm going to hide this plane and this plane. To select this boundary blend, and I'm going to pattern this towards the axis pattern and select this axis. So I need a number of 16 patterns. So enter a value of 16 here. An angle must be 360, and I'm going to give OK for this. So our boundary blend is completed and our pattern is also completed. So you can see the thickness of this is too small, like a sheet. So we need to increase this thickness. So click this boundary blend and go for the thicken. Select this flip direction 2 times for the entire surface. Then I am going to enter a thickness of 0.05, as this is correct for the impeller. You can see here when comparing to this and this. So I'm clicking on OK. So then select on thicken and pattern here towards the all the reference and click on OK. So now our part is completed. You can hide this line for references. So then I'm going to cut off these parts. So for that I'm going to sketch, select the front plane and go for the sketch. Okay, let's go for the revolve option. It is too easy. If I go for revolve, okay, I'm going to, I need like this. So I'm selecting this plane again and dragging it like a front and going for the revolve. So now also it's not good. So I need like this. So I'm clicking it again and go for the revolve and go for the sketch. So now you can see that we have the front option correctly. So we need to draw 2 reference here from this line and for this line. So select reference and then we decide this. So our reference part is completed. So let's draw the line to complete this revolve option. Draw a line from this point towards downwards, and you can draw this without dimension. So we are drawing this for removing this material to get the correct finishing. So only we need to enter this dimension and enter a value of 2. So then we are going to cut this part towards an arc. So we are using this spline option to get easy from here and from this and from this. Okay, so now we are going to drag this like this. You can adjust it by dragging the point. So I thought that this is a correct dimensions. So now draw a center line which is must for the revolve option, and I'm going to click OK. So you can see now our part is completed. I'm going to remove this material. So you can see our extrude cut is applied for this, for this line and for everything, and I'm going to click OK. So our part is completed now. So let's go for the appearances. First deselect all, and I'm going to apply metallic color for this, select an entire part and I'm going to select this. So let's go for the shading with reflections. As you can see here, it look like an exact impeller. You can give some hole here to insert. So for now I'm not inserting any holes. If you want a hole here, you can draw a hole. So let's draw a hole here. Go for the model and go for the sketch and go for the sketch view. So let's draw a circle with the center point to here, and I'm going to enter a value of 0.5 and I click on OK, and I'm going to extrude this to the both the sides and drag it like this, and I'm going to remove this material and click on OK. So now you can see that there is a line that we created. So select this line and hide this. These are the normal issues that we go on through the Brownie blends. So our path is finally completed. You can see. So thanks for watching, guys. So if you want more videos related mechanical engineering or any other content, you can comment below. And don't forget to like this video.